More and more people in Taiwan appear to be bracing for a potential attack from China. There's been a significant increase in demand for courses on what to do if conflict breaks out. As Asia correspondent Brent O'Halloran reports, experts say all citizens have a role to play in times of war.
Open wounds, broken bones and severed limbs. Regular citizens are taught how to handle all manner of injuries of war. It is a mock exercise in a church basement, but participants fear such skills may soon be called upon.
Someday, China might try to invade Taiwan, so it's very important for every Taiwanese to know how to defend our country and how to protect ourselves, our family members and friends.
The Kuma Academy conducts seminars across Taiwan. Backed by a billionaire, it aims to train 3 million citizens in 3 years to teach them what to do in the event China attacks the territory, how to give emergency aid, how to spot the enemy and detect disinformation. Organisers can't keep up with demand.
We really want to make sure that this idea has been promoted to people who do not really care about politics or warfare and make sure that they could come to our places to learn all these skills.
Russia's invasion of Ukraine and China's ramp up in military drills around Taiwan have made such preparation more urgent in the territory Beijing has threatened to take over.
Yes, it's mainly due to the geopolitical situation that I decided to come. I think you need to prepare and prepare so you can help yourself and your family.
On one of Taiwan's outlying islands, residents have been rehearsing the response to attacks. In this drill, a bombing of an oil depot left dozens injured.
In times of war, the army will be in charge of fighting, while we are in charge of support and logistics. We hope that we can help out with our abilities.
In an exclusive interview with Sky News, Taiwan's foreign minister suggested China may attack in 2027. But experts say an information war is well underway, that Beijing is using popular social media apps, bots and other AI tools to sow division and undermine leaders here in Taiwan. And that makes improving the public's disinformation awareness a key part of Taiwan's defence.
Now we're getting more conspiracy theories, in addition to fake news. So I really want people to know how conspiracy theories has been established, how they have been disseminated by foreigners, not just by us.
Taiwan's military and citizenry are readying for the worst. Brent O'Halloran, Sky News in Taipei.